Arkansas.
There's the foul from behind. That's unnecessary.
Well, the thing is, Don, though, you can't put time back on the clock. That's only the second foul. But what you're going to get to now, I think that's the 19th foul on the Cougars. And one more, the Bruins are going to be in the dreaded two-shot foul.
Right. Kelvin Sampson's team now with 19 fouls. And they're down by 9 after scoring 4 quick points. Martin does it. Derek Martin, what a game he had against Pittsburgh. Remember that? He had 15 assists in that game. A school record.
We had 13 last weekend in one of the games.
Murray, big offensive board. Derek, there's that quickness we told you about. Up against McLean, he'll do it himself. Too hard. Rebound, Matthews of UCLA. Not a wise move by Derek.
Well, he tried to avoid running over the top of Don McLean as he was a little out of control.
Over to Martin. Goes along the baseline. Up with a finger roll off the glass. My goodness, what a shot by Martin.
I can't believe he took that shot, and I can't believe it went in. And that's what the Cougars need, is that he felt to come down and bang one in like that.
Delta with a bucket. Martin, by the way, with 26 for UCLA.
Except for defensive matchups, I'd almost be inclined to put in another small guy to shoot the ball from perimeter for the Cougars and leave maybe just Ken Trenton inside.
Foul inside. Terrence Lewis, Washington State, on the right of your screen.
And Don McLean, they're off the court over in the corner. I mean, he got Belton, and the crowd over there was really on him. He turned around and he just started laughing. Here you see it right here. Here you see it. Here's Lewis. Here's Lewis. Push up, push up. McLean pushes right here. Here's the push. There's the push right there, and he's off balance.
I'll tell you. Pro wrestling could have used that.
New business needs demand new thinking.
83-74 UCLA. And the scoring machine continues. McLean, just a junior.
Bruins playing like they're on a mission. I mean, they really, you know, we were here at the shoot around today. They're very serious. I mean, you know, they're fun-loving kids, but they're very serious about this game.
They've had some great wins. I mean, they beat Stanford without McLean on the road after losing to Cal.
And they lost some real tough games. You know, they were only 4 seconds from getting the win at Arizona.
Belton with a big shot. Now back over to Martin. And UCLA is quite simply just taking control of this game, especially in the last 10 minutes. Martin against Derek. And the foul on Neil Derek of Washington State. So, again, it's 2 straight shots.
Yeah, excuse me. And the Cougars wanted a hook. Felt that Derek Martin hooked this man. Should have been an offensive foul, but I couldn't see because of the officials. But I watched it inside. And Brian Payne, it looked like he and Tracy Murray were dancing. He had his arm put around his waist.
Maxie back into the game for Benny Seltzer. Benny Seltzer with 9 points. He in the ball game.
And Jim Herrick just telling Don McLean, tell the guys to get out to the three-point line, take away the three-point shot. Because right now, see, the Cougars have got to get the threes. They're playing the clock as much as they're playing the Bruins.
Martin now with 28 points. I have him down as a previous career high of only 22. So a career effort on the part of Derek Martin this evening. Baseline. Derek trying to find an opening. Ball kept alive. Great job by Sean Carver. The race against Neil Derek. No foul called. Went hard to the left hand, but Carver still comes up with a bucket. Great effort by the youngster.
Really accelerated with the ball.
Ball to Payne. They get the quick two on the pass from Lewis. 2.5 minutes to go. They lead to 13. And the Cougars are beginning to trickle out of here. He's back into the game with those 4 fouls. They need him. Got to get the ball up quickly. 2:13 remaining in the game. Maxie. Derek gets it on Carver. Off the glass. In and out. Everybody can get the rebound. Last touch by the Brewers.
Well, and the Cougars have had so many tough luck with the ball. Up off the board, in the basket, get around to the other side, and then off somebody's fingertips out of bounds.
As Hill comes back into the game. And how many of those shots, David, have been in the paint?
Oh, way down.
There you see. Pass keeps them out of the score. All the 4 points scored by starters for UCLA of their 89.
And on the other hand, you can look at that as saying the group. So the crew has got a lot of guys who come off the bench and score.
Martin just weaves his way around. The shot counts and the foul on Payne. And Martin is on a joyride tonight. He is playing an exceptionally great game.
The thing is, as I look at just our halftime stats, Don, we talked about points in the paint, is that you had Kenny Critton 1 for 4.
I think they're calling it a charge now, I believe.
Yeah, they're calling it a charge. It's charging Derek Martin.
Shot is good, though.
And you know, I heard this comment on a game earlier, and this is the way I feel, too, is I think if you call a charge, you can't give somebody the basket. You can't have a trade-out. That's a rule that has to be changed in college. In high school and pros, if you charge, you don't get the basket.
The Payne goes to the line. Isn't that kind of night for Washington State? I think they wanted this one so badly that the effort was certainly there. The stick around, a lot of other things that the other Titans had to do with it. Hill with a lucky drive against three Bruins. But it's a half.
It's also,
down to 11, David.
Took a big night, a career night from Derek Martin.
Yes.
You know, in the big two, the M&M had to come through with their usual night for the Bruins to get this victory here.
Now we're a minute 20. Leads at 11, and now UCLA obviously will eat up as much time as they can. Well, on Eddie Hill.
And I'll tell you why the students on that side are booing, because from our angle you can see it is what Eddie Hill is trying to check on. Sean Carter, he's a lot bigger, and he grabbed his jersey and pulled him down on top of him. But see, the students don't see that because they're on the other side of the floor.
Carver will go to the line.
But it was a smart play. I mean, if you get away with it, that's a smart play.
Hill has the savvy of a senior, not a freshman. Two shots. There's 10 fouls on Washington State. There's still only 7 on UCLA in the second half. Different complexion of this game in the second half. UCLA, all business, as David said. Carver gets the second.
Well, I think people are looking at on the air and look and say, hey, you know, this is a 10 or 12 point super win. But I'll tell you what, this is a close basketball. This is a hard fought, very well played college basketball game.
Got a timeout. A minute 4 remaining, and we'll have those final minutes of this game in just a moment. 93.
To stay number 1 in facts demands a whole new
way down to Eugene, Oregon, where we'll have 6th ranked Arizona visiting the University of Oregon Ducks. Head coach Don Munson. Cougars, they look good as far as an NIT berth. They want the NCAA. They still need to win at least a couple in their final 4 games, or 3 after this one. The scoring for UCLA: Martin at 28, McLean at 30, Murray at 20. Those three with 78 of UCLA's 92 points.
But Brian Payne was 21, and if you would have told me Brian Payne would get 21 and the Cougars would get beat, it would have really surprised me.
Career high for Brian as well. I know his mother is up right behind us watching the game. As Martin goes to the line again with a career 9 on his own.
And Brian Payne, one of those young men that you, like I said, he's a joy to have in your program. That kid right there is not bad to have on your program either.
191 assists, only 61 turnovers. Yeah, I'll take him anytime. Number 1 in the Pac-10 assists. Set by McAfee with less than a minute to go. The Cougars all want 3 shots. We'll see if Charlie Raines decides if that foul took place outside the 3-point line.
Well, the Cougars coaches were telling him, and that's right, though. That's the rule. You know, it's funny, I've been at quite a few high school games lately because it's the playoffs, and high school doesn't have that rule, you know. If you shoot you on a 3-point line and get fouled, and I talked to one of them, and he says, hey, you get fouled, you get fouled. Try not to shoot shots. So there's a difference of opinion there,
right? Tyrone gets 3. So that cuts the lead to 10. We're 58.3 seconds remaining. And the way the Cougars shoot 3-pointers, I'm not ready to leave my seat. What do you mean?
What was it Yogi said?
Yeah, we all know what Yogi said. We cut down to 8. Here's steal by Juan Thomas, who just came into the game, number 5.
but that's exactly the way you have to play it. You have to play pressure. You have to go for the steal. If you don't get it, you got a foul because you can't afford to let time run off the clock.
And Calvin Sampson let only 1 second go by. It's still 57.9. Good mistake for the tenth of a second up there. That was less than a second.
In your mind, you always want to try to force somebody who maybe isn't shooting the ball well from the line to go to the open spot. That would be, in my mind, Sean Tarver, but it never seems to work out that way.
McLean gets another one. Here comes the crowd. Gets the second. Quickly down court. Three-pointers. By Martin. That's a foul on Derek Martin, UCLA. Lewis will go to the line. 47 seconds remaining in the game.
And that's what the Bruins did not want to happen, is when they made him take this kind of a fourth three-pointer, you've got to get the rebound. And then Derek Martin hits the ball.
Yeah, don't foul.
Oh, the worst thing you can do is stop the clock. Anytime you can score points when the clock stops, that's in your favor. You being an old helmet head, you wouldn't understand that.
47 seconds. And the junior college All-American, the two is figuring. Leads in seven. And a foul. There it is. Adam Mulbert, the referee, calling it on Long Thomas. Trouble is, you got McLean and Murray. Who do you foul?
It's a smart move on it too. They're playing with percentages. You still got to make the guys go to the line and earn it. You know, Don McLean is a great free throw shooter, but the last time there, he missed the first one.
I still like saying, you know, do you want cod liver oil or do you want hot cod liver oil?
But I don't care.
Want to take the minute.
In my opinion, if he goes to the line and makes one out of two, and I come down and hit a three, I'll take those odds any day. It's just that, I don't know if the three is having enough time.
Yeah. 44.3 seconds remaining. Good. Got that second one.
I think he caught that one.
Yeah, I think so too. He had 33 for the night. No foul call. No foul call. Shot clock dead. And the foul on Hill.
Calvin Sampson. Right down here. Yeah. Why wasn't that a foul down there?
Neil Derrick drove along the baseline and no foul call. Remaining in the game, and UCLA, at this point it appears, will move to 9-6 and 21-7.
Hey, I'll say this, I don't care, I'll dispute anybody. I think Washington State can play with anybody else that's being considered in their position for a postseason bid. We know UCLA can.
Arizona State hoping to come up with key victories over the weekend in the Willamette Valley against the few Oregon schools in Arizona as well.
And I really believe that Andy Blahoff had a long two-pointer. Hadn't been injured at Stanford, they would have had a 20-win season.
Juan Thomas with a bucket, down to 17 seconds. And this one is just about history. Nobody there. 11 seconds. And there's the foul. 9 seconds remaining. And a 9-point lead for UCLA. Well, if this margin were to hold, that would be the biggest margin in the last four trips up here. It has been a tight, tight series. They won by only four last year up here, 64.
When you play these kinds of games, and part of these young men on both teams have played, some people say, well, what's not real artistic? Damn good basketball game. There was no white flag set up out here. Everybody plays, there's 9.2 left to go, and they're going to play them right out.
Well, it's like I said earlier, I'm just thrilled about the Pac-10's non-conference record of 80-24, the best since 1978. And last year was one of the best, too. So, obviously, overall, the quality of the Pac-10 is so much higher. And they can get at least 14 in the NCAA tournament. We'll make it the last two of the game, as the final is going to be. Everybody stands up, but we can't read the scoreboard.
I think it was 99-91.
Thank you, folks. I tell you, that's a little difficult with the scoreboard situation. They're down on the 21st victory in the 90-91 season. And we'll wrap things up here on the Prime Network in Back 10 Basketball in just a moment. 8 points.